So, let's handle a ground attack. This meaning you can launch a dropship to attack your enemy. The player with the initiative can launch the dropship first. You can only launch one dropship, but you can place many ground units on them. You have to pay one energy for the launch and one for each ground unit. For example, let's say my enemy wants to start two artillery ground units and the launch the dropship, so he has to pay three energy. Then he places the target marker. You can use any kind of marker, it doesn't make some difference if armor piece in color or whatever. Let's say he wants to land the dropship here. It has to be a plain tile on the map. Then the same happens again like with the attacking missiles. The only difference is dropships have four health points, so they will only be destroyed if you get four hits on them, and they are easier to hit because they are quite huge. So you already hit them with a value of three on your six-sided die, so 3, 4, 5, or 6. Okay, let's start. The dropship coming here, flying here, nothing happens. If I'm here, this anti-aircraft rocket fires. Let's do it. Nothing happens. Then if I'm more forward on this tile here, the second one fires. This is a hit, so it's already get one damage point. And the difference to normal missiles is the dropship can make some emergency stop landing, also land immediately, or return and fly back. So I can try to rescue my ground units before they get destroyed completely. Because if the dropship is come down by anti-aircraft rockets, everything is lost. But okay, I think he will progress, fly forward until this space, and he has only one gun turret. This gun turret is placed here. He also sees this dummy marker, it's nothing. And he sees this dummy marker, it's nothing. And then he plays his artillery units. These units, ground units, can be placed in any free tire, only not on water or on some occupied tires with other buildings or so. But it can be unplanned tires like this here and this here. Let's say he starts that way. The artillery units are good to fire against buildings and have a quite huge range. Okay, the same for the defender. I have one ground unit, a guardian. This is some high armored heavy mech, and the only problem of this mech, I cannot launch him to attack my enemy, but I can use it at my own country to defend it. And I can place any nearby tile to my hangar, one of my hangars, and one unit. For example, if I have two units and I have two hangars, one here and let's say one here, I can place one ground unit nearby this hangar, and one ground unit I can choose really nearby this. Okay, I place it. Now it's turn number one. I use some turn counting dice. It makes for the infantry backfiring a little effect. Okay, now moving, meaning first the enemy can move the units. Artillery tank can move two tiles. Every ground unit can move two tiles, so it's easy to remember. Let's say you think he have a firing range of four, so he go backward until this. Well, not so good, because the gun turret have a range of three tiles, so he can fire 1, 2, 3 until here. So it's better if he go this way and maybe this way. 1, 2. Yeah, he's still in range of this gun turret, but no problem. Okay, then the defending player moves his ground units. He move that way. And now it's attacking phase, meaning he can throw a dice. One dice per ground unit. And depending to the target, for example, if the artillery fires, he has to throw a 4, 5, or 6 to hit a building, or 5 or 6 to hit a ground unit. Let's say both shooting at the gun turret. The first one misses, the second one hits. So the gun turret get one damage point, I rotate it. And this guardian isn't in. It only can fire at the dropship. The dropship is in range, so he fired it. Oh, and it already have one damage point from the anti-aircraft missile. Roll dice. Yep. And a 3, the Guardian hits units with a 3+, so it's already a hit. So the dropship have already 2 damage points. If the dropship is lost before the player, the attacker evacuates its units, the rest of the units cannot evacuate anymore and have to stay until they're destroyed. That's already one turn. We turn the turn counter dice to 2 and repeat everything. Moving the attacker, moving the defender, firing and then firing the defender. Fire of the defender. Okay, let's say we move 2 field, 2 tiles this way. This unit moves there. He progresses. He wants to attack the artillery units. 2, 3, 4. Oh, he have to move only there. Makes no sense. Anyway, okay. And then fire phase. Let's say this artillery fire 1, 2, 3, 4 range to the gun turret. The range doesn't make any effect to the dice roll. It just have to be in range. And this artillery fire at the gun turret as well. And misses. I make a 4, so I hit, and the gun turret gets destroyed. Kaboom, get moved away, and is lost. Then the turn dice count to 3, and so on. Let's explain what happens. This is repeated until the attacker is defeated or retreated, and the turn counting dice make only one big impact. If we reach the 4, the infantry start firing back. Infantry means the defending player gets 1 dice and 1 additional dice per attacking unit. In this case, I get attacked by 2 ground units at the moment, so I get 2 dice plus 1 extra dice, and I can throw them. That's meaning my little infantry running and try to shoot at them. They only hit with a 6 and cause damage. In this case, nothing happens. And yeah, you can choose your target really. So I can say, okay, 2 infantry attacking this unit and 1 attacking this unit. Okay. And if I reach turn number 6, I can stop turn counting. It's just staying here with 6. And the difference is I hit already if I'm throwing a 5. That's all. And so if I'm the attacker, I have to hurry because the infantry is coming. And it's not taking forever, and I cannot walk around the Hugel Island and destroy everything. I have to hurry a bit, and then I should escape if possible. And let's say, okay, we have a new turn. Let's say we are already staying here. Here and here. Just some little modification. And now the attacker's turn starts. I move here, 1, 2, go into the dropship. This ground unit cannot progress until the dropship and have to stay here. But I think, the defender will maybe destroy me, so I already evacuate. So this dropship flying away backwards. And now it's no change to evacuate this artillery anymore, but he can fight and maybe he destroys some more buildings or whatever. In this case, I guess he gets destroyed by the Guardian. And I also can plant some instant unit, like this gun turrets, anytime in game. In this case, make no sense because the Guardian is already overpowered and the artillery have no chance against him. But let's say, I want to instant place this unit because I'm so afraid of the artillery unit. I want to destroy it so quickly. So I place the artillery, the gun turret somewhere and then attack firing. That's close everything about ground unit attack. There's only one thing I guess I not explained already. There's first a Fire Angel. After moving a unit, I can choose the direction I'm aiming for freely. So moving 1, 2, and say I'm moving, aiming this direction. And then my target zone is 45 degree forward. So I can hit this tile, this, or here, and here, and so on, this way, 45 degree. I cannot hit units next to me, on left side or right side, or anywhere behind. And one other thing, if I'm attacking a unit from his back side, if he aiming at this direction, we have the same backside area of its own firing angel behind him. So meaning 45 degree backside and from right backside too. And if I'm shooting from this angel, I get a -2 to the hit throw. So for example, the Guardian have a 3+ throw against ground units. And if I attack the artillery, I already hit with a 1, so I cannot miss. Every dice throw will be a hit. The other thing, if I shooting with the artillery, front side to the Guardian have a armor level of 1. Next to the Titan special unit, it's the only ground unit with an armor. This means the dice throw just get 1 more difficult. And the artillery unit is very bad to hit ground units. They hit them only with a 5+, so a 5 or a 6. If I try to hit a Guardian, I have to throw a 6 to hit him. Except the case he looking to the other side and I'm firing into his back, then it getting 2 more easy, so not a 6. I already hit him with a 4, 5 or 6. That's the only thing about the angel of firing and the backside weak spot. If the attacker managed to escape his units, for example, in this case, let's say he evacuated the artillery and the artillery already have get some 2 damage points. The damage points of the dropship doesn't count. They just, you have a new dropship every turn. Even if it gets destroyed, you can launch another dropship in the next turn just by paying the energy for no problem. But your ground units keep their damage. So this flying back, getting onto the, let's take this, the enemy research screen. He take it back to his hangar and place the damage dice nearby. For example, if I now, for example, have the initiative and launch a dropship in the same turn and attacking his territory and he placing this ground unit nearby some hangar to defend his own territory, he still have the damage of 2 points. And after the ground combat phase, the last phase, number 7, happens is the repair phase. It's quite simple. You have to pay a price of 1 energy or 1 credit and can repair 2 damage points of 1 unit or of 2 different units. For example, if you have 2 damage points at this ground unit, he can pay, let's say, 1 energy, have to move it away from his resource screen, and then this ground unit is fixed. The same for the buildings. For example, if you want to repair his base, you have to pay 1 credit or 1 energy and can remove this 1 damage point, and he have already one more point to repair if you have one thing more damaged. If you have nothing, then it's just for nothing. The point repair gets lost. Okay, that's basically everything. And then the next one happen, we get the resources. The resources you get every turn. If you have only 1 base or 2 bases, it doesn't make some difference, but you have to be in game. If you lost your second, last base, then it's over. That's everything.